Hello, Mr. Roe Knows back again. More GCSE revision, obviously. It's kind of what I do. So.
We perceive mankind as kind of civilized. Order and rules keep us safe. We survive in society because we see the difference between evil and good, peace and anarchy. But we don't always see there's a darker side, primal and savage, that we try to fight. But William Golding brings the raw to light in an allegory, that's right, Lord of the Flies, when a group of boys crash land on an island, they're left to fend with their own devices, with no grown-ups who can lend advice. Initially it seems like a paradise, so they run along the beach and swim in the sea, happy as can be and feeling free. In their innocence they see really and truly the magic of nature and its endless beauty. Sitting in the glade by the water, Simon looks at the water and hypothesizes that the lack of rules will let the boys run wild. He's afraid because he's meek and mild. Holding presents us with different boys, each one represents a moral choice. Ralph is the leader who takes control, tries to unite them with common goals. Now Jack is more savage and he acts so primal, thinks that his leader is in denial. In amongst the others are those who we pity, and opposites who cat around like Roger and Piggy. The novel's allegorical and seeks to teach us that in society we need to keep the peace just by not giving in to our primal urges. That's why we have governments, laws and churches. The little things of note that you might not notice are all key symbols, signs and motifs. The glasses that we see upon Piggy's face represent intelligence within this space, and in time they become a tool they hope to seize, showing us our savagery is linked to greed. Now the boys soon learn that they might be safe, so a fire up high they keep aflame. This inspires them to hope that they might be found, but it's also symbolic and it's quite profound. See, it represents the thoughts of the world outside, a desire for rescue that still resides. But when it goes dark they start to find a mysterious beast this island hides. So they set out to hunt for this evil creature, fending for themselves, no need for teachers or adults, just a constant that now provides them with a symbol to respect and act civilized. And the shell in itself is a symbol for the world that they knew but now know no more. Yes indeed, it represents democracy, it gives the right to vote and the right to speak. But eventually we see the conch destroyed, the demise of the civilized peace of the boys, and the slaughtered pig with his head impaled signals the end of their playful tale. See, the innocence lost is what the book professes in. The Lord of the Flies is manifested, and the darkness inside soon exceeds the love. The title's translation, Beelzebub. Let's end on the note of some useful quotes, like the zone where the stones he dare not throw, that's invisible and strong, this is representing the rules of the world they have left but sense, the protection of parents, school and the law. In the beginning they are held by these mental walls, and Jack's mind was crowded with memories of all the evil deeds that he had achieved, like closing in on the struggling pig and knowing they'd outwitted a living thing. Impose their will upon it with their egos big and taking its life like a satisfying drink. But Simon sees that there is nothing to trust in the beast, and he wonders if it's only us. Then the severed head speaks and reveals the truth. The evil within is just a part of you, and the end sees the darkness of all men's hearts as Ralph now weeps to see Piggy's corpse.
So yeah, the easiest way to look at this book is to consider that within all of us is the potential to be evil and the chance for us to be good, and we have to decide which one we are going to be. The idea that Golding wanted to really get across was that naturally we have this evil inside us, and it's only society and the way which we are raised and brought up which stops us from being this dangerous. And without rules and without society and without various different things that we have to keep in high regard, we would all descend into chaos, and it would literally be survival of the fittest. So yeah, think about that. Anyways, till next time, because there's probably going to be a next time. Good luck, Mr. Roe Knows.